different chassis, Kenny Lamb Racing engine. Beneath the hood, out of Clover, South Carolina, it's Ross Bells. Ross Bells in 87. First lap, he'll trip the loop, 11.964, new track record on the first lap for Ross Bells. He'll bail off into turn three and four, out of turn number four, checkered flag, lap number two, 11.951, 11.951, new fast time, Ross Bells. He will come to life off of two, down the back straightaway, the yellow and blue number one. Green flag in the air from high atop the starter stand. Vic Hill now on the clock. He'll set sail to turn one. Top side of the speedway for Vic Hill. He'll move to the middle line. Down the back straightaway into turn three. High speed for Vic Hill. Up the track. Can he beat Ross Bells? Lap number one. 11.933. 11.933. New fast time. 11.933. 11.933. 11.860, 11.860, new quick time. G.R. Smith in 22. This is his type of racetrack. Hammer down, full throttle. He'll set sail to turn one. Bobbled a little bit through one and two. Had to reset back on the loud pedal into three and four. G.R. looking better. First lap on the scoreboard. 12.467. 1, 2, 4, 6, 7. Much better through one and two on lap two. In the three and four, out of turn number four. Checkered flag. 12.025. The second lap is the quick lap at a 1.2025. Point leader. Third and overall point standings, the Millwood Plumbing. Hitson Construction, Longhorn Chassis, out of Kingston, Georgia. 31 of Tyler Millwood. Tyler Millwood in 31. 11.970. Good first lap at a 11.970. Down the backside into turn three. Top of the racetrack for Millwood. Bobbled in three and four. Gonna cost him. That'll cost him second lap. Much slower to 12.612. A 1.2612. He'll have to rely on lap number one. Tommy Bailey, the black and orange, number 11. Bailey on the gas, out of turn four, green flag is in the air, and he'll set sail for his first of two timed laps here at M&W Transport, hauling it fast time qualifying. Bailey's first lap, 12.352, 12.352, lap number one for Tommy Bailey. Checkered flag at a 12.198. 1-2-1-9-8, the fastest of his two laps. 11.860 is the time to beat a 11.860. Next car on the speedway, the Tennessee RV Super Center, Fleetwood RV, REV Vehicles for Life, Longhorn Chassis, Double Down Motorsports entry, Maryville, Tennessee's Robbie Moses. Robbie Moses in 21, first lap, a 12.225, a 1-2-2-2-5. On lap number one, gonna have to improve if he's gonna move over. Vic the Thrill Hill, 11.860 is the time to beat. Checkered flag, lap two, 12.147. 1-2-147 for Vic, or for Robbie Moses. Robbie, Longhorn Chassis, B&B Performance Power Plant, the 29 of Jason Welshen. Jason Welshen. Looking good, lap number one for Jason Welshen. He'll be happy with this one. 12.202, got to pick it up. Got to pick it up, he needs 4 tenths down the back straightaway. Long back straightaway, sweeping turn three and four. On the throttle, off the throttle briefly, down the front stretch, and a 1.2077, 12.077 for Jason Welshen. Yes. Next car on the speedway, he comes to the white flag for being late up the racetrack. Davenport over the cushion. CNH Paving, Barry Wright race car, Barry Wright house car. Jonathan Davenport only getting one lap. It's a 13.140. Slow time of the group of 13.140. This lap is not timed. And we'll continue on. Really not sure this driver here needs any introduction in East Tennessee. Car number 20. It's a Rocket chassis. Redbone Fishing and Rental, Power Rig LLC, the 20, the new Fort Nightmare, Jimmy Owens. 12.072 on the throttle through 1 and 2. Looking much better down the back chute. Into 3 and 4, the Osho works out of turn number 4. Lap number 2, 11.880, 1.8880. Fastest of the group. Next car on the speedway is the 21K. It is Ewing, Virginia, the first ever super late model start for Dakota Knuckles. Dakota Knuckles down the back stretch. White flag for the Timberline Barnes Rocket chassis, 12.262, a 1.2262 Dakota Knuckles. That Vic Hill power plant screams into turn 3 and 4. Off of turn 4, checkered flag. 12.025, a 1.2025. That's the quickest of his. 101 rolls on the speedway. Out of Talbot, Tennessee, the Trent Logging. Hobson Race Parts, service, subcontracting. Rocket chassis, Eagle Race entry. Forrest Trent in the 101. Forrest Trent on the speedway. First lap, 12.446. He's not going to be happy with that one as he saw the scoreboard rolling off into one. He knows he's got to go. He'll hit set sail, set his mark, set it up on the top side through 3 and 4. Second lap looks to be better. Will it be a 12.445? It's quicker by 1/1000th of a second. Next car on the speedway is the Don's Auto Sale, Ayers Trucking, Automotive Recycling, Longhorn Chassis powered by Cornette Thunder Race Engine. The 5H is defending Battle of the Bluegrass champion Jeremy Hines out of Seymour, Indiana. 12.169, 1.2169, third quick in the group on lap one. Jeremy Hines sets it up, looking good. 12.026, quickest of his two laps. 11.880 in the group by Jimmy Owens. Jimmy Owens, first fastest in the group, top of the charts here in group two thus far. Mac McCarter with an ill-handling race car works into 1 and 2 from Gatlinburg, Tennessee. The Compass Heating and Air Conditioning, West Haven Speed Equipment, McCarter Farms Warrior Race Car. 13.010, got into turn one and off of two, much better here on lap two. He'll shoot down the back straightaway. Mac McCarter fans to their feet cheering him on as he works out of four and across the start-finish line. His scoreboard time is a 12.363 on the scoreboard in turn 1 and 2. All drivers in group two thus far, the fastest lap has been on lap number two. Here's a driver who's no stranger to victory lane on the Ultimate Super Late Model Tour here at the Bulls Gap Speedway. He comes to us out of Sevierville, Tennessee. The Ogles Neighborhood Service Rocket Chassis with a custom race engine is Chad Ogle. Chad Ogle in 10, 12.222, a 1.2222, 12 triple deuce on the scoreboard, and he'll work here on lap two. See if he stays consistent. If he can pick up, it'll be a good lap time here. He does at a 1.2166, a 12.166. Next car on the clock is the Mission Transport Outlaw Southeast, CrossFit Overton. Stone Land Clearing and Excavating. He's your Virginia King of the Commonwealth in Ultimate Action, $20,000 victory in April. It's Brandon Overton on the clock. 1.2082, good first lap at a 12.082, a 1.2082 for the Dream Team Longhorn Cornette Thunder Race Engine. 11.990, second quick in the group. 11.990, second fastest. Next car on the speedway, good to see this driver in action. He has not had as an extensive racing schedule as we're used to seeing for the Allen, Kentucky native. He's got a sweet Bloomquist chassis with an ECR race engine. It's Brandon Kinzer from Allen, Kentucky. Brandon Kinzer, Allen, Kentucky, white flag, lap number one is a 12.182, a 1.2182 for the Shane McDowell Racing Kinzer Drilling Textron Off-Road Quality Natural Gas sponsored Sweet Bloomquist chassis. 12-220 or 12-220. So next car on the Speedway is the M&W Transport, M&W Equipment Sales, C&D Property, Longhorn Chassis out of Gaffney, South Carolina. Two-time and defending Ultimate Super Late Model Champion, Rambo Dennis Franklin. 12-385. Rambo's not going to like that. A 12-385. Rambo's got to pick it up here on lap two. Fortunate for him, he'll be top of group three for now, as the first car on the Speedway in group number three, his second lap is a 12-077. 12-077. Fleetwood RV, Longhorn Chassis, the Double Down Motorsports entry out of Morristown, Tennessee. Put your hands together for Shannon Buckingham. Shannon Buckingham will trip the system. New quick time in the group at a 12-048. Let's see if he can improve. Nobody flirting with sub-12s thus far in group three, and it's a 12-038, so a 100th quicker, or beneath the car, the Phantom race engine beneath the hood for Seymour, Tennessee's Ryan King in car 30. Ryan King is the next one on the Speedway in car number 30. It's the Mighty Muffler, Brian King Roofing, Fox Shocks. Yellow race car works off of four, white flag, first lap on the fairway Ford. Scoreboard is a 12-475. A 12.475, lap number one for Ryan King. Ryan King will exit turn four, checkered flag in the air is a 12-348. A 12-348. Next car on the Speedway. It's a long haul from Headingley, which is in Manitoba, Canada. Car number seven is a Longhorn Chassis Vic Kill race engine for Ricky Weiss. 12-078 for the Western Kentucky Orthopedic Center, AIE Communications, Derek Sandblasting, Hands-On Excavation 7 car from Manitoba, Canada. Ricky Weiss, he went to a backup car. The first lap is going to be his time lap because he had problems here on next car on the Speedway. I know he's got a lot of fans here. Stand up, make some noise for this driver if he's your man. Out of Chickamauga, Georgia, it's car number 17M for the 2005 World 100 Champion and 2014 Dream Winner. It's Dale McDowell. Dale McDowell in 17M. 12-018, new quick time of the group. 12-018. Textron Off-Road, Boyd Speedway, New Era Industrial, Shane McDowell racing entry. 11-873 is second quick overall, and Vic Hill's time is an 11-860. A 11-860 is the time to beat for overall fast qualifier. Our next qualifier is going to see if he can knock Vic Hill off the top of the charts. He comes to us from Marion, Virginia, driving the Petty Collision Rogers Towing GRT race car, the lone GRT in the field for Travis Greer. A 12-660 for Travis Greer. A little hiccup in turns one and two. We'll see if he can get through three and four much better this time. He'll work out of turn number four. Second lap is on the scoreboard at a 12-642. A 12-642. All right, one qualifier left, and here we go. Is car 69, the Bruce Built Performance, Miller Brothers Racing, Brickwood Builders Rocket Chassis, with a button-built race engine, Salem, Virginia's Carter Miller. Carter Miller in 69, Salem, Virginia. A 13-147, a 13-147 for Carter Miller. 13-053, a 13-053, the quickest of his.